Thank you for staying with us, and this is the final part of Sports Tonight. Let's just start off this segment, final part of the show, by going to your messages on Twitter. A lot of people are still talking about our opening issue. Oni and I disagreeing over whether Ihezuo should continue to play if she's within the age bracket or not. Looks like Oni is winning this one because Ogungbe Setonya says, is she the only girl in Nigeria? And
yeah, issues like that we always raise.
Another person should have a chance to play. But those issues will always come up. What's your take on it?
I don't think she should be there all the time. If you're serious about...
Even if she's within the age bracket?
Yes. It doesn't happen, you know...
Maybe once, twice, okay. Three times.
Move on. Allow another. Since we say, or unless the NFF has another opinion, this is development.
Just for us to
allow another person.
Tony simply wants to play the devil's advocate. He knows the truth. He knows. At 19, Raul Gonzalez played at the World Cup for Spain.
Nobody brought him back. Michael Owen.
But
didn't get to play for the under 20s.
But my issue is, it depends on the amount of talents available to you.
There are talents, for goodness sake.
It depends on that. I mean, we all know what the problem of our women's game is.
The talent is not
so, the issue. So to be able to scout talents properly is always an issue.
NFF do not put the coaches under pressure, a lot of people don't like to hear that. If you don't put those coaches under pressure and you don't say, go there and win.
I think the problem
is... We've been in the final of this tournament 2 times.
Yeah.
Tony, the problem...
It's the same approach.
The problem is that some of these coaches have program, but where is the funding to execute this program? You know, if the devil comes out with a program that, okay, give me so-and-so to go around the country...
I want to camp for such a long period of time, and they tell you, look, we don't have time for that kind of camping.
Just
that's why...
2 weeks of the competition.
You're not beginning to agree with my point.
So it's not an issue of talent.
That should be the reason he should, use one particular player for eternity.
Yeah.
It's not going to work.
Okay, Enyoma Daniel says, I wish the Super Falcons all the best of luck and victories. Please, who was the first Nigerian player to win the African Women Cup of Nations as a coach? I think we talked about it. To Kerry Auche. I did it in 2010. She did it in 2010. All right. Dende Elvon Sani says, I think players like Sophia Omidiji should be given the chance. I think that's one foreign-based player who's been talking about what she can do. She should be given the chance ahead of those who have participated more than twice. All right, that's coming through. You mean final part of Sports Tonight? South African Wad van Niekerk.
Yeah, received a special recognition
award.
Association of National Olympic Committees for his feat at the Olympics. Let's not also forget he's in the running to win the IAAF Male Athletes of the Year with Usain Bolt, and like, it was a phenomenal year for him. Broke records, and a lot of people are saying this is the next Usain Bolt, so we'll wait to see. But this makes us proud as an African that he's been able to achieve this feat.
Okay, final word on the show tonight as we wrap it up. Los Angeles 2024 Olympic bid leaders have allayed concerns within the Olympic movement following Donald Trump's U.S. presidential election victory, insisting that the candidacy would continue to celebrate our diversity. That's our final word on Sports Tonight this midweek. We'll see you again tomorrow. Enjoy the rest of the night. Bye-bye now.